Good day and welcome to Godly Thoughts and Ministries. Thank you so much for joining us. May the Lord continue to increase you. May the Lord continue to bless you. May the Lord continue to do good for you and your family. Today we want to talk about acknowledging God. See, there's so many wonderful things that God does that we as people do not acknowledge. And God makes the point that he mentions it in Hosea 11, where he says from verse 1, "When Israel was a child, I loved him, and out of Egypt I called my son. The more they were called, the more they went away. They kept sacrificing to the Baals and burning offerings to idols. Yet it was I who taught Ephraim to walk, and I taught them by their arms. I took them by their arms, but they did not know that I healed them. I led them with the cords of kindness, with the bands of love. And I became to them as one who eases the yoke on their jaws, and I bent down to them and fed them." So, before we get to this scripture, we want to explore some of the ways that God uses here to show that he's always there helping, but sometimes we are the ones who go away, we are the ones who refuse to acknowledge him, and who seek after what we think we need, not look right in front of us at what we need and acknowledge it. Let's pray. Father, I thank you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, for the brother, for the sister, for the person on the other side of this camera, that they may acknowledge you in all your ways, in the wonderful things that you do for us, that they may acknowledge that you are good, that you are great, that you are wonderful. I thank you in Jesus' name, I pray. Amen. Listen, God does not demand human acknowledgement. God does so many things. If you wanted to be acknowledged for each and every breath you took, you would have demanded it. If you wanted to be acknowledged for each and every time you blinked, you would have acknowledged it. If there was a tax you had to pay for breathing in oxygen, you would have accumulated a huge debt. God, all he wants is for you to worship him, to acknowledge him, to thank him for the free gifts that he gives you. God is King. God is Lord. But he's also the Father of all mankind. That's why he says, Israel was a child. He is my son. I called my son out of Egypt. Just like every father speaks. When the son is misbehaving, he concerns himself with how he has done everything to make sure things between himself and that son is fine. You know, he says, I pulled him to myself with bands of love, with bonds of compassion. God was always there, guiding, leading, showing his hand to you in many times. And yet, some of the people who are so blessed refuse to acknowledge God. I see it in my life. People who love God so much, who are always praying, sometimes don't have as much as those people who struggle in life. It's just like the parable of the prodigal son. Someone once explained it to me from the conception, from the perspective of the other son, not the prodigal son. The other son who was always there, always working, always obeying, but never getting a goat for him and his friend to slaughter and have some fun. This other one got everything and was now being celebrated when he came back after squandering everything. Sometimes people feel like that. You know, there are some people who seem to have it all and yet they are far away from God. And yet life is like that sometimes. We too draw ourselves away from God. And yet God does everything for us. What is it that God doesn't do? If it is wisdom, God gives it to you to do business. And some of you are very successful out there. Because God gives you wisdom every time to do better, every time to do well, better than you did last time, better than you have ever imagined you could do. God makes sure you have that wisdom. Why don't you acknowledge him? Why don't you give him your love and your heart? Why don't you trust him to take care of you when he started doing so way before you even knew him? I need you to understand that acknowledging God is not just in saying, I believe God exists. Acknowledging God goes so much far beyond that. It is in understanding his word. It is in taking time to spend time with him. It is in taking time to say, God, I love you. And showing that you know who he is in the way that you fellowship with him from time to time. In the way that you fellowship with others from time to time. In the name of God. One thing I can assure you of today is that many young people, people of my age, or younger, etc., do not want to acknowledge God. They want to see more proofs of God. And God has done so much from the beginning of time. He doesn't need to prove himself. He already died for you. He was already crucified for you. What more do you want him to do? It's like a parent who has exhausted all their strength to make sure the child is taken care of. And yet they are being told they should do more. They should do more so. And then they are saying, look, I don't know what else he wants me to do. I sent him to school. I fed him. I took care of him. I was with him all the time. I literally threw away my life so that he can have the one that he has. And yet he still wants me to keep on doing. Imagine God letting go of his only one and begotten son, who was innocent of all crimes, by the way, to be accused falsely and to be tried. It's impossible. You can't do that. But God allowed it to happen because of love. And the son himself said, I am not forced to do this. I lay down my life on my own. He understood the love of the Father for the flock, that is us. The love of the Father for the people, that is you and me. And he understood what he had to do to win back those people. It only took his blood. It only took his intercession for you to be saved. And yet after all that which he did, a lot of us still trouble to even find 2 minutes to pray to God. Listen to what God says, the word of God says, I took them up by their arms, but they did not know that I healed them. Do you know that a lot of things that God does, he works like a background application. He doesn't come forward and demand to be acknowledged. He heals you of your illnesses. He intervenes in your situation. He mends your heart. He appears in many different forms through many different people, gives you advice, direction, guidance, love. God is still the one continuing with you. He started with you when no one ever cared about you. He started with you when no one liked you. And yet he's still continuing with you. And yet those people that throw you away and treat you like garbage, they're the ones you always get God back to and you do not acknowledge God. Listen to this. Yet it was I who taught Ephraim to walk. I took them up by their arms. See, I taught Ephraim to walk. It's like a father recounting memories of the wonderful time he spent with a child. Seeing a child grow, seeing a child learning to walk, seeing a child do all sorts of things brings joy to a parent. And it breaks the same parent's heart when that child simply just throws away the parent and focuses on other things. At this time, Israel was being impetuous. Israel was going after other gods to save them. You know, it's hard for a child that you did everything for to just throw you away and look for whatever else they have got going out there. Think those things are cooler than you. Let you go. Focus on whatever they think is important. This is the situation that God is talking about. This is the situation that the prophet is referring to, of God pouring out his heart, God pouring out his love, and expecting you to acknowledge that he is wonderful, to acknowledge that he is good, to acknowledge the good that he does, and at least give an effort. In most cases, we don't give an effort to acknowledge God. At least just say, Lord, thank you. All right, if you don't want to pray, just say, God, thank you. Find ways from time to time of thanking God. See, the problem is that not only do we not want to pray, we don't even want to consider the need for God to be acknowledged. We say, it's an old idea by the crazy people who couldn't explain events that are happening. But now we have got scientists who can explain these things away. These people thought God was this, they thought God was this, and we think we're too clever. But there are certain times where we are pushed to the corner, where we find ourselves needing God, where we find ourselves needing a higher explanation for the bad things that happen in our lives. And unfortunately, that's when many people tend to Eastern meditation, where people tend to white garment churches, where people tend to witch doctors. That moment when you really need an explanation for your life, that's when you must come to God and seek God. You will be amazed by the things that he will do for you. When you acknowledge God, when you walk in his path, when you read his word and meditate upon it and even share it with others, God turns around even the most difficult situation in your favor. And within 1 year or within 2 years, God will do for you what took others 20 years. God will do for you what took others their very souls to achieve. Because he loves you, and all he wants is to have a good relationship with his children, as every father does. Let us pray today. Father, I thank you for my relationship with you. I acknowledge you, the good things that you do, the food that you give us, the breath that you give me to breathe, the work that you give me, Lord God, the opportunities that you give me to fend for my family, the way you take care of us, when I lie down and sleep, I rest in your hands, I rest in your arms, protected by you. I know that I will never worry of anything because you take care of me, you watch over me, you protect me, you love me. I encounter your presence, I encounter your love every time. I thank you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ for my brother, my sister on the other side, for the love that you continue to show them as well. In Jesus' name I pray, amen. Well, thank you for joining us, and remember to subscribe and invite others to this channel. God bless you, and have a blessed day.